no plans, no plans at all. Evil man's always transcending. Fight her like sheep, swallow everything. Always simpletons or pretending. We got no plans.
This is your moment of clarity from LeeCamp.net. So I have some great news, folks. The Republicans and the Democrats in Congress and the White House finally came together and agreed on something. This is huge. These guys disagree on everything. Getting them to see eye to eye is like getting the Israelis and the Palestinians to do a trust fall together, or getting Eskimos and polar bears to play Jenga. I'm referring to the bill H.R. 347 that was signed by President Obama the other day and passed unanimously in the Senate and 388-3 in the House. That's nearly every single lawmaker. The last time they agreed that closely on something, it was a bill raising monthly congressional pay to include a box of ding-dongs, two erotic cakes featuring Bonanza star Pernell Roberts, and a gentle yet inquisitive prostate exam every Tuesday. What did this magical, universally loved bill say? Well, many are calling it the anti-Occupy law because it allows the government to bring charges against Americans involved in many kinds of political protest at any location the Secret Service, quote, is or will temporarily be visiting. So basically, if the government wants to shut down a protest, they just send a couple of Secret Service down there to scratch their balls for a second, and then they start putting people in jail for a year or more. This is all lovely, except for that bitchy, bothersome document, the Constitution. I believe somewhere in the back it says, quote, Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech or the right of the people peaceably to assemble. Ah, shit, that must have sucked when Congress found that out. To get that close to passing the bill and then shot down, it must have been like getting hired to rub baby oil on the contestants of Miss Universe before the bathing suit portion of the competition, and then losing your hands in a freak cell phone exploding accident. Quick side note, why isn't baby oil more expensive? You figure they must have to process 5 or 6 of those little fellas just to get one bottle. So when Congress heard about that First Amendment thing, they must have been like, God damn it, that really fucks up all our plans. That fucking line in the Constitution says not to do exactly what we wanted to do. That's what they must have said, right? Right? They didn't just like pass it, and then the president didn't just like sign it, right? But the bill doesn't stop there. I mean, when you have the entirety of Congress, with the exception of Ron Paul, agreeing on something, why not swing for the fences? The bill also says it could be a federal crime to protest near an event of, quote, national significance. Well, that's not vague at all. So you could be convicted of a federal crime and locked away for a year or more for the following things: marching outside the Democratic or Republican national conventions, yelling, cockface corporate whore, outside a barber shop where Mitt Romney is getting his ear hair trimmed, marching in front of the entrance of the New York Stock Exchange, sprinkling magic homosexual glitter on Rick Santorum, or even anyone near Rick Santorum, or even just making fun of his stupid sweater vest, or going to the gates of the White House and demanding the president read the Constitution, you know, if he gets a chance in his free time. Well, if Congress gets to stomp on the Bill of Rights like this, I want to do it too. I want to bring back cruel and unusual punishment, and then we could demand that every man or woman who voted for the anti-protest law or signed it from the Oval Office be tied up in the town square naked for a week, while everyone who wants to gets to throw fire ants and bumblebees at their naughty bits. Deal? That's your moment of clarity from LeeCamp.net. Do your own research on H.R. 347. Look it up, tell your friends about it, sign the petitions online, and protest. And by the way, if you enjoy Moment of Clarity, if you think you got 50 cents worth out of this video, then please become a member at LeeCamp.net for as little as $5 per month. Thanks.
Plans, no plans at all. Evil man's always transcending. Fight her like sheep, swallow everything. Always simpletons or pretending.